Let us join together in the prayer of joys and concerns. O redeeming God, as we begin this new year, we remember how you have cared for us and comforted us by speaking your love into being. Trusting in your faithfulness, we bring our prayers for the world. We pray for your church in all its many forms, that it may speak to the needs of all the diverse people of the world. We pray for the world, that all might experience your love made flesh through justice and peace. We pray for those lifted up with joy, for Anne and John's new grandkids arriving in April and May, for Alex, Marjorie's friend, who's making great progress in his battle with cancer, still heading towards an all clear. For Matt and Ellie, John's brother, expecting their first kiddo. For Candy, whose back door at work is buried in that rock slide, but no one was hurt, and for that we are very grateful. For Bishop Davidar, who retired from his leadership position in the Methodist Church last night on the stroke of midnight, may his retirement be joyous. What other joys do we wish to lift up this day?
Dave was finally able to have his hip surgery this last week.
Yay.
So I'm going to ask for prayers for a speedy recovery, but also prayers for patience for him so that he doesn't push too fast.
Right.
Even more patience for me as a caregiver.
For David, that his hip surgery, which has been long scheduled and postponed, is finally here and done, and we are so grateful that he is recovering. May he recover well with patience and grace, and may everyone who needs patience in this process get what they need. What is your joy today, KJ?
It's a wonderful life that we get things that we want to do.
It is a wonderful life that we get things that we want to do. Amen. Wonderful things that we love to do. Other things?
My daughter Amy and her husband Scott's anniversary today.
Amy and
Scott.
Scott's anniversary today. What a brave couple to plan a wedding through the Christmas season to be ready on the other side.
Well, they had to decide. They got married before midnight, so they had to decide tax-wise.
For the practicalities of marriage built right in from the beginning, we are truly grateful.
Yeah.
Oh, it is a joy having David and Sarah here with us today.
It is a joy to have Reverend Smith and Sarah with us today.
Sally.
I'm so sorry. A loving God, may these joys become even more our own to share them with the world. We pray for those who suffer and who are weighed down for concerns, for the families who are getting help from Share to make this Christmas season a merrier one, especially the two families we supported, for Cassie, Amy's mom, who fell and broke her hip, may she continue to recover, for Jim, Donna's dad, who's still getting his meds balanced out, for the friends and family of Matthew, Jessica's childhood friend, who died of a brain tumor, leaving children and parents behind. For the friends and family of Morris Nicholson, John's father, who passed away at his home in Arizona after a long illness. For the friends and family of Andrew Candy's four-year-old cousin, who passed away less than a week after catching the flu. For those touched by the death of Pope Benedict XVI, they might know the love that surrounds them. For those touched by the death of Barbara Walters, a figure in many of our life, who told us it straight and surprised some of the people she addressed. Are there other concerns to lift up this day?
My cousin Wendy has asked for prayers for her son, Rick, who has been diagnosed with stage 4 kidney cancer.
Oh dear. For Rick, Nancy's cousin, who's been diagnosed with stage 4
kidney cancer.
I was just about to say liver, and I'm like, no, that's not right. Kidney cancer. May he get the help and support that is out there and that is amazing, and the strength to endure the treatment.
This is from township.
For my friend Carl and his children, my high school friend, whose wife passed away yesterday from a very sad battle with brain cancer.
Oh. For the friends and family of Carl and his kids, John's friend, who lost his wife to a battle with brain cancer.
Beth.
May they know the love that surrounds them.
Harry asked for prayers for her co-worker, Joanna, whose baby was overdue, was fine on the 23rd, but not on the 24th, and delivered on Christmas morning.
For Joanna, whose baby was delivered on the 25th in the morning, for the concerns that come with a baby transitioning from okay to not okay, and that the delivery sometimes is more frightening than what had been leading up to it.
For John Panto and his family and all that they're going through right now?
For John Panto and his family, they have had a tough week with people entering hospice and then a couple of members of the extended family passing away. It's been a tough and busy week. Oh, loving God, let our care for all these people be a new incarnation. We pray for your creation. Make us healers of this earth. We commend to you into your hands those who have died and praise for those who now journey towards death, that they may rest assured in your promises. One Christ, one with Christ, one of Christ, and sealed in the Holy Spirit. We praise and glorify your name, Holy One, now and always. Amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.